Bill Belichick is preparing for his 9th Super Bowl as Patriots head coach, but he still had time to give props to Rams defensive coordinator Wade Phillips before New England headed to Atlanta. Belichick said his own schemes have changed over the last 30 years, but Phillips haven't. He added, quote, "The system has lasted. I have a ton of respect for what he's done and how he's done it over every different kind of offense you can see." So Sean Merriman and Shannon both played Wade Phillips. Shannon, yes. I'll let you start with this one. Mm-hmm. What do those comments from Belichick tell you?
He's right. He's absolutely right. If you go back to Coach Belichick, Coach Belichick is a 3-4 defensive coordinator, cover two, very, very little pressure. He's not willing normally to take the safety out of the middle of the field. Wade Phillips has always had pass rusher skill. A lot of people don't know. Wade goes back to New Orleans when they had Ricky Jackson, Pat Swillings, Sam Mills, Von Johnson.
Yep.
Then he goes to Philly, Reggie White, Jerome J. Boogie Brown, Clyde Simmons, rushers, Buffalo, Bruce Smith, Bryce Pop. He goes to Denver, Von Miller, D-Ware. So he's always had pass rushers.
This guy.
And, yeah, exactly. Defensive Rookie of the Year.
Yep.
So he's always had guys to go get after the quarterback, with the exception of
J.J. Watt, too.
Exactly. Yeah. So he's a pressure guy. Yep. Coach Belichick, really the exception, he's had a few. But not to the extent that Wade had. Now, LT, that's a whole different argument. But the way they played back then, Skip, Coach Belichick was a cover two.
Yep.
I'm going to play cover two. I don't believe you. I'm not going to give you anything cheap or deep. Mm-mm. But what we've seen lately, he's branched out. He's gone to a little bit more four down lineman. He will come with a single high safety. Mm-hmm. He will come with zero blitz on you. That's not Coach Belichick. We know Wade Phillips has always been pressure. Mm-hmm. And he always will be pressure because he has guys that can go get after the quarterback. When you have an Aaron Donald, when you have a Reggie and a Bruce and all these guys, Sean Merriman, you let them do what they do. Mm. Go get the quarterback. We're going to heat him up. We're going to make the ball come out quick, and good things normally happen. Yeah, you're going to give up a few plays.
So would you conclude that Wade Phillips has had Tom Brady's number?
I wouldn't say he's had when you got – the rushers that he's had. Mm-hmm. You look at what he's had now, Skip. When you got two guys, and D. Ware is going to be in the Hall of Fame, and Vaughn is on the Hall of Fame level.
He is.
And they had guys in the middle that could collapse the pocket and sit the pocket in his lap so he can't step up. Mm-hmm. Tom Brady, really, Skip, he wants to stay in that area. He wants to stay in that 10 by 9, 10 feet, 9 yards deep. That's all he wants to do. Mm-hmm. Well, Malik and D. Wolf was putting their offensive lineman in his lap. Mm-hmm. So now he can't step. He has to slide right to Vaughn, or he has to slide right to D. Ware. Mm-hmm. So Wade is like, this is who I am. Mm-hmm. I'm a 3-4 guy, but I'm going to heat you up. Mm-hmm. I'm not dropping my best guys. Occasionally, he'll drop Sean Merriman to the hook flat. He'll drop Vaughn or D. Ware to the hook flat.
Yep. Just keep everybody honest.
But just to let you know, I ain't blitzing him every time. Yep. But 90% of the time, he's wanting Sean Merriman to put his helmet in your chin.
Mm-hmm.
My rookie year when I came in, and I missed a few weeks of training camp because we had a contract dispute. And I wasn't,
which year
I
was this?
Time. It was 2005.
Five.
I came in, so, you know, I didn't understand the playbook. It was just moving too fast. And by the third or fourth practice, I said, Coach, but I can't pick it up. This is Wade Phillips. I said, Coach, I can't pick it up. You know, him and along with a few other coaches, they took me in a meeting room, and they all circled around me and said, Sean, we're going to line you up, but after that, I want you to see ball, go ball. Mm. I said, Coach, what you mean by that? He said, we're going to line you up. We're going to tell you which side to go on.
Yeah.
And after that, we want you to get after the quarterback and go make a play.
Mm-hmm.
Wade Phillips has always done exactly what he needed to do with his best players. If you do something extremely well, you're going to do just that. And if you can't, you won't do it. He'll bring you off the field. He won't put you in a situation where
you can't succeed.
You can't succeed. He wants you to win. Unlike some of these other coaches who are going to say, you know what, this is my scheme. I want you to do this because this is what we do best. Wade Phillips is a total opposite. If you can do this well, you're only going to be doing that. That's why I do believe early on in the season when he came in and Rams were struggling, playing a little bit, and their defense dropped back and they couldn't play the run, they were getting gashed some other places because they didn't have those outside linebackers. They didn't have those pass rushers dating back to some of the guys that you said back in the day, even back in the Bills, Cornelius Bennett and Bruce Smith. Mm-hmm. And fast forward to myself, and he had Sean Phillips on the opposite side. Well, you go and you take over the Rams where your star players in the interior. They're the interior D linemen.
Right.
You don't have anybody in the outside. So early on, he was trying to make the defense cater to the inside guys. They were running upfield, getting gashed to run. Mm-hmm. That's why they went out and got Dante Fowler. because they believe that we need somebody on the edge who, when these guys collapse the pocket, as you just said, they collapse the pocket on the inside, mm-hmm. we need somebody who's capable of making a play on the outside.
So and he made the play in the NFC Championship game in overtime.
Exactly.
Yeah. That year, 2005, a weird thing happened in week four because you went up to Foxborough. I don't know if you were playing that much at this point. Maybe you're still struggling.
Yeah.
But this is the aberration because Tom has met up against a Wade Phillips coach mm-hmm. team nine times. Tom is 6-3 in those nine games. But this is the aberration because you guys won that game 41-17 at Foxborough. Mm-hmm. Brady and company had just gone to Pittsburgh and beaten a Steelers team that was on its way to winning the Super Bowl that
right.
year.
Okay.
So I don't know if they took you lightly or they were a little bit like it was a little bit of a letdown, but you guys just ran them off their own field and it got all the way down to Brady got replaced late by Matt Castle, who threw a late pick six that got it all the way to 41-17. Do you remember the game?
I do. I didn't start to game eight, to right. game seven, eight in the middle of the season. I think, and we still had Drew Brees. In 2005
it was a Drew
well.
Brees game.
Exactly.
Yeah. So that was the one where Brady was kind of hapless in this game. He had a long, hard game. Drew was pretty good in this game.
And that's what you do. You yeah. cater to what – and yeah. people don't realize the pass rushers that Wade has encountered in his defensive – as being a defensive coordinator's head coaches. So these guys – I mean, what are you going to do? Oh, Reggie, we just want you to catch. We just want you to play a two-gap and play down the man. No.
Yep.
Get on the edge and go.
I'm with you.
And so that's what he does. He caters to what you do really well. And he says, go do it.
My bottom line to this game, it's a matchup between Wade Phillips and Tom Brady. Mm-hmm. And if I could pick any coordinators to go up against Brady in a Super Bowl, I would pick Rex Ryan or Wade Phillips.
Oh. And what did they both do? Pressure.
They'd go yep. after the quarterback. Because both have had some success against Tom Brady.
Because a lot of what right? Wade's philosophy is very simple. Mm-hmm. Wade's like, when you get to Tom Brady, you get to Peyton Manning, you get these guys to see everything, it's about out-executing them.
Yep.
Can you do what you do better than what they do? Now, they're going to disguise it. Now, they're just not going to just line up, okay, it's too deep, or it's 20, you know, it's cover five, 22 man. No, we're going to disguise it a little mm-hmm. bit. But look here, Aaron Donald and Dominican Sue. Fowler, Brockers, mm-hmm. you got to go get home. Now, occasionally,
Ebukam.
Now, occasionally, Skip, they're gonna bring, they're gonna blitz a guy because they're gonna keep you honest. They don't think think they're just gonna come straight four man. Oh yeah, mm-hmm. he gonna bring some pressure. He gonna heat him up because you got to, Skip. If you give Tom, these quarterbacks are too good, mm-hmm. and it's just like anything. If you give these great quarterbacks, the Breezes and these Breezes and the Tom Brady's, a steady diet of anything. It's just like with anything. They'll build up a tolerance to you, mm-hmm. and they'll beat you.
So last night, they asked Wade, how did you pull off what you did in the AFC Championship okay. games? The last time Brady was kept from the Super Bowl right. after the 2015 season. Mm-hmm. At Denver, it's 20-18, and Brady had a QBR of 37, which on a scale of 0 to 100, not very good. Mm-hmm. And what did Wade say? I had good corners, and I had Vaughn and DeMarcus. Okay. Well, that's how you do it.
Because
they had good corners. Yeah. They had three good corners,
yeah.
right? Maybe four good corners.
Because they would take Harris and bump him inside on Edelman. And so now you got Roby outside, and then you got Tlaib.
And what was the other variable? There was no Dante Scarnecchia coaching the offensive line for the Patriots.
You got to if to beat a Wade defense, mm-hmm. you got to hold up against pressure.
You do.
Because he's going to come. Ooh. He's bringing it.
Well, Steam can't come soon enough, right? That was really interesting from all you guys. Sean, good to see you. Thanks for being here. Speaking of Sunday, will it be Rob Gronkowski's last game ever? We'll discuss all that next.